Continuing from the last section, let's say we didn't want to use the button to update the label, but instead have the text box do so automatically. As expected, the first step is to add a text changed event to the text box, and then set it to update the label. However, if we try the application now, the label won't update. This highlights an important point. For a server-side event to occur, a postback to the server must take place, so it can process the event and send us back a new page. The only controls that automatically trigger a postback are the three button controls. For the other ones, we need to explicitly set the auto-postback property to true to achieve this result. Running the application this time, the text box correctly fires a postback to update the button. Note that this happens only when we leave the control, not while changing it. Every time we make a postback such as this, the page load event handler will execute. To stop this method from running code on a postback, we can check the isPostback property of the page control. If it's false, the page is loaded for the first time. To end this section, let me point out that HTML server controls can also have events, similar to the web controls, but Visual Studio won't support us much in adding them. All the events belonging to the document object model will show up on IntelliSense, even those that can't be added to this control, and they can't be displayed in the properties window.